how the Spanish GP was a massive turning point for Mercedes. It was only a matter of time, wasn't it? I've been saying from the get-go, do not write off Mercedes until they are completely out of sight when it comes to the championship. I know they didn't go and win the Spanish Grand Prix and lost even more points to their rivals, but they took a significant step forward in round 6 of this 22 race season. Not only this, but they've been getting a truckload of points most race weeks in a car that hasn't exactly been anywhere near its optimum level. George Russell is only 36 points off Max Verstappen at the top of the drivers. Hamilton is quite a bit further back, but there is plenty of time left. You just can't write them off yet. You really can't. George Russell secured his second podium of the season to continue his excellent run of form and even battled the two Red Bulls, which turned out to be for the race lead after Charles Leclerc. Am I able to come to terms with it yet? Come on, Matt, pull yourself together. After Charles Leclerc retired from an easy race win. I now know how you feel, Max fans. It really does hurt, doesn't it? But anyway, this is about Mercedes, and they looked bloody quick this weekend, especially in the hands of Lewis Hamilton. I cannot stress enough how impressive the 7-time champ's race was on Sunday. He had that minor collision with Kevin on lap 1, which he was incredibly unlucky to receive a puncture from, and once he'd crawled back to the pits and was back out, he was 38 seconds off the back of the pack and almost a minute behind the leaders. A minute! And had soft tyres only a couple of laps fresher than the cars out in front. Yeah, he was pretty emotional after his puncture, wanting to potentially retire the car, and even I sat watching and was like, come on, Lewis, you know that one safety car changes everything. Thing is, we didn't get a safety car, red flag, or anything to help the Mercedes driver. And on pure pace, he still got back up to 4th, which became 5th after the car issue, of course. Mercedes brought a few changes this weekend, including a revised front wing end plate and changes to the floor edge, rear corner and floor body. The big result, at least visually for us watching, was the reduction in porpoising once more. There were comments from both drivers that there was still a bit of bouncing mid-corner, but overall, especially with Hamilton's smile on his face after Friday, you could see they'd taken a step forward. Toto Wolff also said after the race, "Can we fight for a world championship? You bet we can." Which are pretty ominous words from the Mercedes boss who has won 8 constructors' titles in a row. I think the reason he says this pretty confidently is the fact that the Circuit de Barcelona-Catalunya is a track that is extremely car and setup dependent. If you don't have a decent working car, you won't be fast. Hence why there's a big feeling that Mercedes will certainly be in the hunt from here on in. Lando Norris said earlier in the season that Mercedes are the quickest car in slow speed corners, so maybe, just maybe, Monaco may be a track that suits their car even more. We will have gone from Spain, which is one of the least driver-influenced tracks for lap time, to Monaco, which is one of the most driver-influenced tracks for lap time. You have to have some serious minerals around that track. It should make for an interesting race, or at least qualifying, I suppose. There you have it, how Mercedes are feeling incredibly optimistic after the Spanish Grand Prix. What do you think? Do you think they're back? Let us know in the comment section below.